All right. So last year I did a travel talk, and this year I decided to do another one because people seem to like it. This year we're talking about the cult of packing. Yeah. So on the internet, there's lots of crazy people. And there's this group of folks who are totally committed to taking the most slimmed down list of things with them no matter where they go. And, you know, here are some quotes. Overpacking tops the list of biggest travel mistakes. I would debate that. There's a lot of things you can do wrong. So these are folks who carry on luggage only. They never check a bag if they don't have to. They will wash their underwear in the sink and other things that prevent them from having to carry on bags, which is a little weird. This is some U.S. domestic bag fees. This is not a lot of money, but the injustice of being charged for this service has ground these people into the floor, and they've decided that they're not going to take it anymore. So here's some hardcore packing insanity. This is the bundle method of packing, and if you've never seen this, you should look it up. It's a very specific recipe for how to get all your shit into your bag. So these folks are totally anti-denim. You should never wear jeans, and you should never take them when you travel to Europe or anywhere else. You always take these messy-looking, never-been-ironed piece of crap sort of pants with you, so everyone knows you're a tourist. You should also wash all your clothes every couple days in the sink, because everyone loves to wear half-washed laundry. That's a fantastic feeling while you're traveling away from home, is to have this sort of damp laundry on your body. Here is a perspective picture. This poor woman had packed all her stuff in a bundle and set it next to her cat so you could see how big it was. It's so small. It's awesome. Just put it in the bag already. They are also very enthusiastic about the kind of underwear you're wearing. You should be wearing quick dry undergarments, and if you're not, you are not part of the cult. You know, you have to pay for these, $38 for this t-shirt here, and get used to wearing damp clothes. These people love to blog about what they're packing. They post pictures, they post packing lists, they'll tell you all, they're like vegans, right? They'll tell you exactly what they're doing all the time. They're proud of it. And this happens all the time. This is the light version. This is women's magazines. This is an InStyle magazine I picked up at the Hudson News, Newark Airport, yesterday afternoon. What you can aspire to pack with you when you're going for a city hour or a country place. They're totally anti-wheelie. You should never take a bag with wheels on it because then they know you're not part of the cult, right? On the right here, we have the Tom Bent Aeronaut. Very, very popular bag. I confess to having one of these, and this is my particular packing list for a trip I took a couple of weeks ago. This is all the crap I take with me. I'm a high-maintenance sort of person. And yeah, it's 24 pounds of stuff that I take with me. And here it is in one bag. You can see the fine pair of sneakers that I have and all these other little things that are finally folded up in nice little packages into their little containers and all these very fancy things. It's very important because I belong to the cult. This is the Aeronaut. These are made in Seattle. It's all very friendly and happy and all these things. Has a backpack straps on them so you can see me humping them around in airports everywhere. It also has this awesome shoulder strap. This is why I do this, right? I live in New York City, and on the left we've got turnstiles in the subway. They are not wheelie friendly. They're not wheelchair friendly. They're not baby stroller friendly. They're not big packages from Berdolf Goodman friendly. They're not friendly to anybody. Other products that you can use if you belong to the cult, you've got packing cubes to put all your stuff in. All your socks have to be separated from all your underwear in case they have this incestuous relationship and all these things happen and you don't know what you're going to end up with when you get to where you're going. And so, we're kind of people that sort of focus a lot on the journey and maybe not so much on the destination. And, you know, you've got a gratuitous photo here. These folks were living a nice vacation in Mexico and, you know, we get a tourist photo of their suitcases. So at the end of the day, who cares? You know, just get on a plane, go somewhere awesome, visit something. This is an aerial shot of my neighborhood in Lower Manhattan, you know, the other day as I was finally getting home from Salt Lake City after 27 hours. And so thank you. Thank you for coming tonight and putting up with all of this.